Hello students, so I am again here with class 11th poem Childhood by Marcus Natan. If we take this poet, we can say that we do not know much about this poet. Yes, authentic things are not available because somewhere some people say that he is a Norwegian poet. And some people say that yes, he is Australian writer who wrote this poem. So we cannot be sure about this poet. But this poem, Childhood, we can say, it's very beautifully written poem. And it is also said that this poet wrote this poem when he was just 12 years old. This is also somewhere it is written. Again, we say that we cannot authenticate anything. But poem is there. So this is the reality. So poem is really beautifully written. Childhood. And we can say that main idea, the theme of this poem is, the main idea of this poem is loss of innocence. Because when the poet is talking about loss of childhood, it means actually he is talking about loss of innocence. This is what he feels, that when we become adults, we no more remain innocent. Because maybe this practical world cannot, or we can say this practical world does not allow anybody to remain innocent. Maybe if one is to survive. So let's start with this poem. And before we start this poem, we can say here the poet actually ponders over this question, that where is the childhood gone? I have told that maybe he wrote this poem when he was 12. So he has crossed 11 years, crossed this phase of childhood, but he doesn't know. When did he cross this phase of childhood? He's not sure. Okay, so let's start this poem. When did my childhood go? This is the first question. And this is the only question with this poet. That when did my childhood go? He wants to know. Was it the day I ceased to be 11? Now, he himself is trying to give the answer. There is nobody to give the answer. So he himself is trying to guess. He himself is trying to give the answer. Was it the day I ceased to be 11? Ceased means stopped. He said, is it that when I stepped into 12th year of my age, when I stopped to be 11, is it that I can say that yes, maybe that was the time when my childhood left me? Was it the time I realized that hell and heaven could not be found in geography and therefore could not be? First guess. He says, can I say that maybe after 11 years when I stepped into 12 years, and maybe you may get this question, why 11 only it is written? Maybe because he was first of all 12 years old, and maybe he felt that at that age, when he was 12, he was able to differentiate between right and wrong, or differentiate between things. He was able to differentiate. So that's why he says, can I say that maybe that was the point when my childhood left, when I was able to realize that hell and heaven are nothing. Okay, this is only in your mind. This is the product of your mind. Otherwise, hell and heaven are no places. Okay, it does not exist anywhere. You cannot find these places. Okay, you cannot find the places with the name hell and heaven in any geography book. If it is not given in any geography book, it means maybe it is actually not there. This is what he says. Can I say that maybe when I was not convinced with heaven and hell idea, or when I realized that heaven and hell is nothing. Okay, there is no place in heaven, there is no place on this earth which we can say this is hell or this is heaven. He says, should I say that was the end of my childhood when I was able to realize that these places are product of mind only? Was that the day? Then again he says, when did my childhood go? Was it the time I realized that adults were not all they seemed to be? He says, should I say that it was the end of my childhood when I was able to understand adults? In what way he was able to understand adults? That they have two faces. They are double-faced people. Means from outside they are something, from inside they are something else. He says, can I say that was the end of my childhood when I was able to realize that adults are not what they look. Okay, they seemed to be what they look. They talked of love and preached of love, but did not act so lovingly. Now he further explains in what way they have two faces. He says, actually they talk of love, they teach the lessons of love, they preach the lessons of love to their children, to the younger ones. Whenever they talk to the younger ones, whenever they talk to other people, they talk about love only, that how lovingly one should live. But they themselves did not act so lovingly, but they themselves, they never practice this love. Means they preach something, but they practice something else. So maybe he was hinting at the word hypocrisy, that they are hypocrites. He says, can I say that was the end of my childhood when I was able to realize that, when I was there to realize that adults are actually hypocrites, because they teach love, they preach love, but maybe in their own lives they have cutthroat competitions, and that's why they have no love for anybody. They just become selfish and they think about their own material progress only. She says, can I say that was the end of my childhood? Was that the day? When did my childhood go? Was it when I found my mind was really mine? He says, or can I say that was the end of my childhood? When I was able to control myself, when the mind was really mine, means I was able to control my mind. It was not overpowered by other people. It was not dictated by other people. I was a master of my body as well as my mind. He says, can I say that was the end of my childhood? Was it when I found my mind was really mine to use whichever way I choose? He says, can I say when the mind was fully under my control, means whatever way I wanted to use, I was able to use. Because when we are children, we take orders from others. We take suggestions from our parents. We do what they suggest. But when we are adults, we are able to take our decisions. And then we are able to use our brain, our mind, our heart, okay, in our own way. We are able to control our heart, control our body, control our mind. He says, can I say that was the day when I was also able to control myself, control my emotions, control my mind? That was the day of the ending of my childhood. Producing thoughts that were not those of other people, but my own and mine alone. He says, can I say that was the end of my childhood? When I was able to have my own thoughts. Producing my thoughts means my thoughts were mine only, based on my own experiences. I was able to take the decisions based on my own experiences. And these decisions were not other people's decisions. Means it's not that these were overshadowed. No. I was able to think I was able to take decision. He says, can I say that was the end of my childhood, when my mind was my mind, my thoughts were my thoughts, my decisions were my decisions. He says, maybe that was the day when my childhood left me. Now, one thing you should realize, I think you might have seen, there are repetitions of certain lines. When did my childhood go? Second para, when did my childhood go? Third, when did my childhood go? In the same way, first para ending line, was that the way? Second para ending line, was that the way? Third para ending line, was that the way? You may get any para, and then you may be asked about that what poetic device is used. So here, write down somewhere, refrain, okay, R-E-F-R-A-I-N, refrain. So this poetic device is refrain, and refrain is actually when certain lines are repeated, okay, in the paragraphs. So here these two lines are repeated, so it means the poetic device is refrain, okay, just to emphasize certain things. Okay, or we can say refrain, mostly refrain means the summary contains over there, summary is there. Okay, when did my childhood go? It means we can see that maybe this whole poem is about this thing only, when did my childhood go. Okay, now we come to the last four lines. Now these three paragraphs are there, and he is trying to come to one conclusion, trying to get to that time when his childhood, we can say, left him. Is it when he was able to know that heaven, hell is nowhere? Means now he was able to understand the world maybe in a more proper way, or maybe he was able to rationalize the things. Okay, second para, hypocrisy, when he was able to see the hypocrisy in people. Okay, sorry. And third para, when he was having his own personality, he was able to control himself, individuality we can talk about. Okay, now we come to the last four lines. Where did my childhood go? So one thing is clear, that childhood is gone. He's missing his childhood. Childhood is already gone. Okay, but now next question comes to his mind. Where did my childhood go? When one thing is sure, that childhood has gone, but where it has gone? Okay, it went to some forgotten place. Okay, when did my childhood go? Actually, where did my childhood go? Actually, he's talking about maybe innocence. Where has my innocence gone? Because when we are grown up people, we are no more innocent. So maybe he's thinking about that only, that where has the innocence gone? It went to some forgotten place. And now, because this innocence cannot come back, he cannot call back the innocence. Okay, and that's why he says maybe to some forgotten place. Because in this practical world, you cannot survive with innocence. So maybe that's why he says it has gone to some forgotten place. Because it has now become a memory only. But it cannot come back. That's hidden in an infant's face. That's all I know. Now, where can you get that innocence? Because innocence otherwise cannot come back. But here he says, if you look at the face of an infant, face of a child, you will see the innocence over there. So if you are relating your innocence to childhood, so if you want to see that childhood, see that innocence once again, so this innocence you can see in the face of an infant. And that's all I know. He says, this is what I can say, that if you want to take back, if you want to enjoy once again that innocence, if you want to experience that innocence to some extent, then you go to some infant, because infant's face is very, very innocent, because they have not seen the practical world. They are so small, they are so young, and that's why maybe innocence you can find there only. I hope you have understood. So very quick recap in Hindi, ki yahan par poet kya dhoond raha hai? Bachpan dhoond raha hai, keh raha mera bachpan kahan chala gaya? Nahi malum kahan chala gaya. अपने आप अंदाजे लगाता है, कहता क्या मैं ये बोलूं, कब गया मेरा बचपन, क्योंकि उसको ये दोनों क्वेश्चन नहीं मिल रहे। सबसे पहले कि क्वेश्चन उसका यही है कि बचपन कब चला गया, उसको पता ही नहीं चला कि बचपन खत्म हो गया। अब वो खुद अंदाजे लगा रहा है कि क्या बचपन तब मैं मानू चला गया था जब मुझे ये समझ आ गया था कि हेवन हेल स्वर्ग नर्क कुछ नहीं होता, ये सब बातें हैं, ऐसा कुछ है ही नहीं, किसी किताब में नहीं है इसके बारे में डिस्क्रिप्शन। तो जिस दिन मुझे ये समझ आई तो मैं मान लूं कि मैं बड़ा हो गया था, या फिर वो कहता कि मैं उस दिन मानूं कि मेरा बचपन शायद खत्म हो गया था जब मुझे समझ आने लगी थी कि बड़े जो हैं वो कहते कुछ और हैं लेकिन अपनी जिंदगी में करते कुछ और हैं। हम लोगों को तो सिखाते हैं प्यार से रहो, दोस्तों से झगड़ा मत करो, लेकिन खुद शायद अपने ऑफिस में बहुत कॉम्पिटिशन में रहते हैं, कोई प्यार नहीं होता। तो कहता कि मैं मान लूं कि शायद मेरा बचपन तब चला गया जब मुझे ये बातें समझ आ गई। या फिर वो तीसरे पैराग्राफ में कहता कि क्या मैं ये मानूं कि मेरा बचपन तब चला गया जब मैं अपने डिसीजन खुद लेने लायक बन गया था, मुझे अपना मन किसको कहते हैं, हार्ट किसको कहते हैं, इसको कंट्रोल कैसे करना है, डिसीजंस कैसे लेना है, सोचना कैसे है, किसी और की बात को ना सुनकर खुद डिसीजन कैसे लेना है। कह रहा जब मैं ये सब सीख गया मैं मान जाऊं कि मेरा तब शायद बचपन चला गया था। कंफर्म नहीं है कब बचपन गया था, लेकिन फिर नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन उसका आता है कि आखिर बचपन चला कहाँ गया। यहाँ पर हम कह सकते हैं उसका बचपन का कहने का मतलब ये था कि वो इनोसेंस, वो सादगी मन की कहाँ चली गई। और फिर वो कहता है कि ये कहाँ गया, शायद एक ऐसी जगह पे चला गया जहां से वापिस आना मुश्किल है। लेकिन फिर वो कहता है अगर फिर भी इस बचपन को, इस इनोसेंस को कभी देखने का मन हो तो शायद एक छोटे बच्चे के फेस में आपको दिखेगा, क्योंकि उस बच्चे के फेस में अभी कहीं भी कुटिलता नहीं आई है, उसके मन में कोई कुटिलता नहीं आई है, तो उसके फेस पे जो दिखता है बहुत स्पष्ट दिखता है, सब चीज सामने दिखती है और बहुत क्लियर नजर आता है, कोई भी हेर फेर नहीं है। तो कहता शायद अगर हमें अपना बचपन, अपनी इनोसेंस ढूंढनी हो तो वही एक जगह है जहां पर हम इन सब चीजों को दोबारा से महसूस कर सकते हैं। आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड। सो वेरी सिंपल पोएम, सो गिव 2-3 रीडिंग्स एंड यू विल एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड। थैंक यू।